Bill. How are you?
I am doing great. I'm so glad. You know, I realized it was an early morning request, but I thought, who better to talk to today with the unofficial end of summer than Jax? So first of all, tell me about your song.
As in Force Field?
Yeah, this Force Field. I love it. It sounds great.
Thank you. It was awesome to record. The writers on it were great. It was like a super cool souvenir to take from Idol. I mean, it was really awesome. I've been recording a lot of new material. I haven't really thought much about it, but.
So I got to ask you, is it busier now after Idol? I mean, what happens after, you know, Idol ends, and now does life just pick up dramatically? What is a day in a life of Jax today?
Yeah, I thought I'd have kind of a minute to relax, but it's been really super, super hectic. I've been writing and recording a lot, like every day almost. For a potential new album, I don't have a date yet, released yet. I've been doing a lot of press interviews and has a lot of gigs coming up and just talking with a bunch of labels and people right now, and everything is kind of in the works and kind of crazy because after the show, like a whirlwind of opportunity just kind of smashed in the face and unexpected, but it's everything I could have dreamed of and more.
So, you know, I love to hear that. You sound so positive. And of course, I've always said this about you. You've got one of the best attitudes of any young star that's out there. You're positive. You're energized. So I love talking to you about this stuff because I think so many people have a different view of that celebrity lifestyle, and it always seems that there's always a negative attached to it, and not the case with you. So I appreciate that.
Thank you so much.
So let me ask you, I don't know if you heard, I was talking about the Jersey Shore earlier. Now you're a Jersey girl, you're from East Brunswick, and I love the Jersey Shore. I am annoyed that the unofficial end of summer is actually the end of summer, and the lifeguards go home, and yeah, No one goes to the beach. And I'm thinking, I want to spend every weekend at the shore in September. It's when the water's better. So I'm calling for a later start to the school year and lifeguards to the first week in October. What do you think?
I think it's brilliant.
There you go. Thank you, Jax. There you go. Someone that appreciates my crazy ideas.
I mean, no, I feel like every student in New Jersey would appreciate that idea. You'd have everybody being Team Bill. You just contact all the high schools.
That's it. See that? Now, I was noticing this morning on Twitter, so many of your fans, your fan base, they're outstanding, by the way. Now, they're all in class, so I felt compelled to tell them, don't cut class. Don't worry. I'm going to, you know, we're going to record this. I'm going to post this to the website so that they can hear you. I think they would love it. It's a shame that they had to miss your conversation with me this morning because they're in class, and it's going to be 95 degrees today.
Oh, gosh. No, yeah, I know. Some of them, it's good that you encourage them not to because they probably would have slept to the bathroom. They're so hardcore.
They are hardcore. They really are. Hey, how are the elderly Jax fans doing? I know you did a couple of those. You visited the retirement centers, and you've got these octogenarians that are doing the Jax X. They love you.
Yeah, they're great. Oh, my gosh. It's really cool because, like, I think the majority of the Jax Packers in general are, like, really, really young and my age. And then there's like kind of a lower point in between, and then it goes like straight to the seniors, and it's just as hardcore. It's really cool.
Right, it like jumps from 16 to 86.
that's
impressive, Jax. Most people can't do that. Last thing, you're doing this, we're going to actually air it on Chasing News on Thursday. You're doing this corn maze. So this farm in Jersey carved out a corn maze in the image of your face.
Real. So I Googled it, and like they really do that kind of thing. It's like I saw a Garth Brooks one. I remember seeing that, and I was like, oh my gosh, this can't be real.
Man,
can't
you're in real. Good company, right?
Oh my gosh. It's like unreal. I don't even... My face is I just can't even process it. And it's like, they want me to think I'm cutting a ribbon. It's just so, it's so
now,
crazy.
You think it would be embarrassing though, if you can't find your way out?
Oh yeah, that's going to happen.
Right.
I have no sense of direction whatsoever. So
neither do I
get lost in my own face.
Right. These, you know, I've heard all kinds of tricks. You got to put your left hand on the wall and follow it. No, there's no trick that works. I end up having to call somebody, help me out. I don't know. I'm about 100 yards in and I don't know where I am.
My trick is GPS and map.
There you go. GPS and the Jack's map will get you where you need to go.